Hello everybody, welcome to MotoLabDirtBikes.com. I'm your host Rob Kosler. Today in this video what we're going to do is show you how to easily remove the rear shock from our 2013 KTM 690 Enduro R. So you just need a few tools. It's kind of buried in there and might seem a little daunting at first, but it's really not that bad. So we've got a few basic tools here for you. The trickiest part probably for you guys at home is going to be getting it supported properly. You could use a standard automotive jack with a rubber pad or a 2x4, get it up off the ground, and use, if you have small automotive jack stands, you could do it on the rear pedestals of the frame, because actually the motor is an integral part of the chassis on this on the bottom, so it's a lot of a bare exposed motor. So getting that done so you can get your rear wheel off the ground and allow access to get to the shock. So what we're going to do is go over a quick tool list for you here. This might be relatively incomplete. 8mm 3/8 drive, 10mm 3/8 drive, a T25 Torx to gain access to remove the rear muffler, and also a T45. I think it's T45, yeah. And so it's all just basic hand tool stuff. So what I'm going to do is just go ahead and focus on getting all this stuff off, and maybe I can do some voiceover for you. So let's get started.
Begin by removing the seat, pulling the rubber strap towards the front of the bike, which will unlatch the seat and pull the seat off and store it. Grab your T25 Torx bit and remove the two bolts that hold the muffler heat shield on. Remove the heat shield and set it aside. Grab your 10mm socket, loosen the band clamp that holds the muffler onto the header pipe. Then loosen the rear fairing bolts, 8mm on either side. Pull the fairing outward as to remove the fender from the clasp. Remove the 8mm side panel bolt. Next, we'll take and remove the two upper T45 bolts that hold the grab handle on. And we'll need to remove one more 8mm bolt that's up on top. This will allow us to move the fairing out of the way far enough to gain access to the two 10mm bolts that hold the muffler on. Take your 10mm socket, zing out the two bolts that hold the muffler on the bike. Go ahead and remove the muffler and set it aside. Next, grab your 10mm socket and zing out the two 10mm bolts that hold the lower section of the tank on. Set those aside. What we'll do is you could go ahead and lift the tail section straight up. And for example, I used a rubber bungee cord to go ahead and latch onto the grab handle and attach to the handlebar. Now we're ready to go ahead and take the T45 Torx and remove the upper shock bolt. I left this one in place temporarily. And then we'll move around to the other side and remove the lower T45 shock bolt. Lift up on the swing arm and pull the bolt out at the same time. Now you can go ahead and remove that upper shock bolt. Set that aside. Voila, there we go.
And there we have it. As you can see, it just takes a little bit of time, a few simple hand tools, and just using common sense when you're pulling this thing apart. Really, the trickiest thing is just making sure that you have that tank supported properly because you have all that weight over the rear end. I used a rubber bungee to hook it up onto the front side of the handlebars and onto the grab handle on the back of the tank. If you might have to get a little bit of creative, and just keep in mind that this is merely an example. By all means, always consult your service manual for your individual machine or application, and be safe. So use your head. Thanks for tuning in again, and really appreciate you guys out there. Check us out. Stay tuned to the YouTube channel or the new videos on MotoLabDirtBikes.com. Thanks, everyone. See you later.